Hey folks, welcome to today's show and tell. My name is Joey Fameli. I'm a video producer here at Tested. Therefore, my show and tell is something video related. It's actually a video tool that I've been using on essentially every set for the last few years. That is the 1985 version of the Minolta Color Meter 2. Some of you guys might know what a light meter is. Color meters are actually kind of a different tool. They only measure the source of the light. They have nothing to do with the camera, really. It's more about just checking the color of lights. And being that, especially we at Tested, operate so much in a world of practical lights, LED lights, tungsten, Fresnels, all these different light sources, it's important for us to measure the color temperature of those lights so that we can match them up and then give that data to the camera to do the white balancing in the camera. But also it's much bigger than that. It's about preventing what's called a color crossover. I'm gonna talk about the VR series we did as a prime example of this. And the VR series is a 180 experience. So the frame is 180. And what we were finding was that throughout a shop, as you're looking through the headset and you're looking at a full shop, you're getting lights that are all sorts of different color temperatures. Only like the very, almost imperceivable by the eye. When you're on set and you're looking at it, you're like, no, it looks fine. But when you're actually looking at it through the headset after you bring that footage back, it's interpreting those colors slightly differently, and it's not handling them as well. And your eyes aren't there to do the job to kind of neutralize it itself. So what we were seeing was just color bleeds and color crossover all over the place. You get this like big yellowish spot on one side of the room and a green spot over here and a blue spot over here and this magenta, the skin tone's magenta over here. So to solve that issue, what I was doing was every day, every morning, we'd walk into a set, walk into a shop that we're gonna shoot in, and I'd walk around and basically check the color temperatures of all the different lights of all the different sides of the room to know like, oh, either this is gonna be a problematic part of the room or we should turn that light off, or maybe we can gel that one over there and kind of neutralize it to match the source of light that's behind our camera that's lighting the subject, if that makes sense. Now, looking at it in this frame, when I was setting up this garage, you see behind me, I have these very orange practicals, what are they called, string lights kind of popping down. Above that is a fluorescent light. These are all shop lights. These are all practicals. And then in front of me, I have my film lights. So before I even struck those, I went back there and I checked the balances. I first checked the string lights and I saw that those were way too warm. Not only way too warm, but like the tint was like super yellow green. So I took some dulling spray and actually just dulled them out quite a bit. So you're getting a much dimmer version of that and it's not spreading the light out so much, but it was still casting a bit of weird kind of greenness. Then what I did is I turned the fluorescent on above it and I checked that temperature and that was adding more green to the situation. You had I can't remember exactly what the temperature of the light was, but the tint was making everything behind me very green yellow. So that told me that I could neutralize that by using some like purples or going to the opposite end of the color spectrum. So I grabbed some purple gels and I put them up there and then did more readings until I got something that matched closer to like a neutral tint and then a white balance that I can adjust these lights to. So with that neutralized, I came up here and I knew, because I did another reading, I knew exactly what to set these lights to because they're bicolor LEDs, and did a reading on those as I changed it. And it turns out these LEDs are slightly inaccurate. So when it tells you, hey, it's 4,000 Kelvin, it's actually registering like 3,500. I knew that because of the tool, so I was able to compensate for that, dial that in to be neutral, and then I can go a little bit warmer if I want a little bit warmer skin tone. So it's really like, it's a measuring device, not only for the camera, but for a room. I can really walk around, I can measure lights and things that I can't quite pick up with the eye, but I know that the camera will pick up. This will help me not only find those problematic areas, but then like give it, make it a math problem, essentially. Take gels and start reducing that number down. There's even like a light balancing index that'll tell you which gels you want to bring it to a neutral. But I have so many different colors of gels, I was able to mix and match and audition lights and quickly audition something, try it on the meter, see what the number is changing to, and then go from there. Not even have to use the camera, so to speak. So it's a great pre-production tool to walk around and do things and get everything ready so when the camera hits the ground, hits the sticks, you're closer to a starting point. And it's kind of fun. I mean, you know that I'm a little obsessed with lights. It's just kind of fun to figure out what different lights are doing to an environment and how color rendition is happening. It's really cool for me, at least. Why the 1985 version? Well, these things run about $2,000 a piece. They're pretty expensive. This was on eBay for like, I think I got it for $250, and it was a steal. There are some that I think are like iPad versions that they connect through Wi-Fi or Bluetooth, and they're just the sensor part. This actually comes off if it ever broke, if you ever needed to change it. I don't think I could ever get a replacement part for this, so this is, will stay on here forever. But the iPhone versions are essentially this piece, and then the iPhone gives you the data. Oh, this is at this color temperature and this balance. So I'll definitely play with one of those in the future, but as of right now, 35 years old and still running great. Every now and then it needs a little, like it kind of freezes up and you just gotta give it a little hit, but I mean, I'm 35 and I need that every now and then as well to keep going. So that again is the Minolta Color Meter 2, the 1985 edition. You can probably still find this on eBay if you're really into it, or just look up some of those iPhone versions or iPads if you really want to play with it. Well, thank you guys for checking out this show and tell on my color meter. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.